This is cell phone video shot by students during a class at Kopachuk Middle School last February. We got a copy from an attorney but agreed not to show the kids' faces. She is representing the 13-year-old boy on the floor covered up by chairs.
It was a teacher-led bullying incident of epic proportions.
Joan Mell, not revealing the boy's name or the name of his family, but she says they're all traumatized by what happened under the classroom supervision of teacher John Rossi.
Sure, the teacher poked him in the belly. The teacher turned around and put his bottom up in his face and said he felt gassy.
Hey, and by the way, I'm feeling kind of gassy.
He had a pillow placed on his face where he couldn't breathe for several seconds. He had his own socks shoved into his mouth.
The Peninsula School District says it got a look at those videos right after the incident.
I was horrified by what I saw.
And acted quickly.
We immediately placed the teacher on leave.
After an internal investigation, Rossi was suspended for 10 days, reassigned as a substitute teacher for the rest of the school year, given new classroom management training, and assigned to a different middle school this fall.
We took what we think is pretty significant disciplinary action against the teacher.
We were not able to contact the teacher by phone, but in a letter written to the district, John Rossi apologized after the incident, explaining he didn't view the incident as, quote, anything more than harmless childhood horseplay. But the boy's attorney says the teen hasn't been able to return to class after the incident, has switched schools, and required psychiatric therapy.
It wasn't horseplay because there was no play going on.
This incident happened earlier this year, and it's still an open investigation. Pierce County Sheriff's Department said they interviewed the victim. They're still waiting to get information from the school's investigation, though, Randy. So there's a lot of questions here as to why this wasn't immediately reported to the sheriff's office by the school. The superintendent, though, did say that Rosie was interviewed immediately after the incident. Disciplinary action was taken. A third party was brought in to investigate. He was brought back into the school system and put as a roving substitute teacher, and that's how he finished out the school year. He's back on administrative leave now.
Is he? So he's still under investigation, right?
It's still an open investigation.
Okay.